At the corner of South King and Richard Street in downtown Honolulu, there's a curious building that stands out amongst its steel and glass neighbors. The Hawaiian Electric Building, with its red shingled roof and bell tower, looks like it could have been lifted from a medieval Mediterranean town. But the building itself and the people it's housed have always been at the forefront of progress and innovation for the people of Hawaii. Built in 1927, the building can trace its history back to the early days of urban planning. A noted New York architect, Bertram Goodhue, while on a visit to Hawaii, would plant the seed to the building's style.
He was invited out by what was still then Oahu College, Punahou School, to come out and give some lectures on art in America and things like that. But he ended up doing a series of sketches about what should Honolulu look like. And one of the things he argued was it was roughly on the same latitude as Acapulco and some of the Spanish colonial towns. And he said it would really be appropriate for Honolulu to become like a Spanish colonial town.
Goodhue's plans would play an important role in shaping downtown Honolulu. The post office building in Honolulu Hale also echo this style.
They really kind of mined a little bit of Mediterranean style architecture, a little bit of the architecture of formerly Islamic Spain, Cordoba, and places like that to create this building that kind of evokes something of Spain.
Although the style evokes a romantic past, the building has always been home to those looking toward the future.
When they opened up, the main feature was the big first floor showroom. It's about a story and a half. They created in this showroom area a kind of a model home. In other words, they set up rooms like a living room and a kitchen and a bedroom so customers could come and walk through and see what it would be like to live in a home with all electric appliances. It's hard to imagine now, but you know, that was really revolutionary in the day.
It became a place where the Oahu community would gather as the company electrified the island.
Of course, they realized the people who'd been cooking all their lives on coal or wood, didn't really know how to cook electric. So they began having cooking classes. And eventually, those became so popular, they absolutely filled up the auditorium on the second floor. When that got to be too much, when there were too many people that wanted to attend those, they started the electric kitchen.
The electric kitchen engaged and entertained the local community for 11 years from the second floor kitchen studio.
This has really been the building that exemplifies Hawaiian Electric in the minds of most people here in Hawaii.
But as we recognize the building's storied past, it's important to remember that it's the passion and the vision of the people who occupy its offices that are its true cornerstones, and serving the people of Hawaii its foundation.